by the Pharisees. He would not denounce that he was miraculously healed. And in anger, they threw him out.
Hurry, we must find him. I must search his heart. For I want to believe. For he is speaking to you, and you have seen him. Yes, Lord. I believe. I have come to give sight to those who are spiritually blind. And let those who think they see know that they are blind. If you were blind. But your guilt remained because you claim to know what you are doing. Accept me today or perish.
Thank you. wrestler company. But I want to let you know today that I am alive. And I am well. I'm still in the blessing business. Larry McDowell. Orchestra. Our whole brass and woodwind section. Thank you. synthesizer, Sean Patterson. All right. I want you to sit for a few more minutes. This is the most important part of our ministry right here. Would you just bow your heads? Father in heaven, we magnify you. We thank you for what you've allowed us to do. We thank you for how you've ministered to us and through us. We thank you, Father, that your people have received. And Father, we're just going to be in agreement with you right now that you're still perfecting people. You who have begun a good work in us, Father, will perform it to the day of Jesus Christ. And we know that you're faithful to complete it. With your head still bowed and your eyes still closed, if there's anyone here today who has never received Jesus as his or her Savior and Lord, and you want Jesus in your life, the Bible says in Romans the 10th chapter in the 9th verse that if you would confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. It says, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. See, we used to believe that you had to feel something in order to get saved. God didn't tell you to feel it. He said, confess it and believe it. Your salvation is not based on what you feel. It's based on what you confess and believe. So if you have not confessed Jesus, according to the word of God, you're not saved. Joining the church does not save you. Shaking the preacher's hand does not save you. What saves you is confessing Christ as your Savior and Lord. Believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead. That's where salvation is. You may have been in church all your life and never have really received Jesus as Savior and Lord, and you want to do that today. If so, would you just lift your hand? Anyone here today that wants Jesus in his or her life, we certainly want to minister to you in that area. If that's you, would you just lift your hand? Anyone here that's unsaved that wants to get, I see your hand, sir. Is there another? Anyone else that wants Jesus in his or her life? This is your opportunity. Oh, we know that it's Easter morning, but that's what this is all about. The angels in heaven are shouting right now because one raised his hand. But there, no doubt there are some others who've never really received Jesus. You may have been in your church all your life, but never really invited him in your heart. If that's you, just raise your hand. Anyone that wants to receive him today, we're going to lead you through a prayer of salvation. Are there others? If so, just lift your hand. You might say, Pastor, I know I got saved, but I have lost some of that joy. I don't even feel saved, whatever that means. I just don't have any zeal anymore. What you need is an assurance of your salvation. We want to show you that you can know that you know that you know you're saved without a shadow of a doubt. If that's you and you need an assurance of your salvation, would you just lift your hand? If you want to know without a doubt, I see your hand back there, sir. Is there another that wants to know? There another. Don't be ashamed. If there's another, I see your hand, sir. If there's another that wants to know, you can know today. You don't have to leave here with a question mark in your mind or in your heart. You can leave here today knowing that if Christ came back today, you would go home to be with the Lord. Is there another? If so, just lift your hand. If there's another that wants an assurance of his or her salvation, if so, just lift your hand. See, we've already prayed for a crop. We've already prayed for a harvest. So you came here totally free to do what God wants you to do. You might say, well, Pastor, that's not me either. I know that I once was saved, and I know now that I'm living the life of a sinner. I know that I'm a backslider. The Bible says, if my people, in 2 Chronicles, the 7th chapter and the 14th verse, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then will you hear from heaven, forgive their sin, and heal their land. What God is saying is that you need to make a U-turn. Doesn't matter what you've done, doesn't matter how bad it's been, doesn't matter how long it's been. What matters is that you now repent and ask God to allow you to come back in the fold, and God will receive you. If that's you and you want to rededicate your life today, would you just lift your hand? Anyone that wants to rededicate his or her life today, you want to come back to the body of Christ? If so, just lift your hand. Are there those? Are there those? Well, bless God. One other option. Well, two. The Bible says, be ye not drunk with wine, whereas in excess, but be ye filled with the Spirit. We believe here that Christians are to be filled. You don't have to be filled with the Spirit to go to heaven, but you do have to be filled with the Spirit to have power. So if you want the power of the Holy Spirit operating in you, then you can receive him today. We will minister to you from the Bible so that you will know, lay hands on you, and then you will be Spirit-filled. You can't believe that with your head. You have to believe that with your heart. Those that want the power of the Holy Spirit operating in them, would you just raise your hand? Anyone wants to receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost? You say, but I'm Baptist. Then you could be a Spirit-filled Baptist. But I'm Methodist. You could be a Spirit-filled Methodist. Denominations have nothing to do with this. So that's for sanctified people. All the people that go to heaven will be sanctified. Sanctified simply means set apart. It means holy. Amen? And God says, be ye holy as I am holy. So if you're not Spirit-filled and you want to be Spirit-filled today, would you just lift your hand? If you want the power, don't worry about what anyone else is doing or saying. If you want the power of the Holy Spirit operating in you, would you just lift your hand? Last option. If you believe the Lord sent you to this ministry and you're looking for a church home and you believe that God wants you to be a member of this fellowship, we certainly want to receive you. If that's you, would you just lift your hand? Anyone wanting to be a member of Crusade? I see your hand back there. Is there another? Is there another? Anyone else that believes that God sent them here today to give their fellowship to this ministry? We certainly want to receive you. Are there others that want to be members of Crusade? If so, would you just lift your hand? All those that raised their hand for any one, two, or three of these options, would you stand to your feet? If you raised your hand, would you stand to your feet? Hallelujah. 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 I'm not going to have you come down front, but where you are, I want you to just bow your heads. Father in heaven, we thank you for these that have come. We thank you, Father, that they came for salvation, assurance of salvation, rededication, Spirit-filled, Father, and to be members of Crusade Christian Faith Center. We thank you that those things that they're desirous of right now are theirs in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for the crop. We thank you for the harvest that you have allowed us to have this morning and to witness this morning in the majestic name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we are so careful to give you the praise, worship, honor, and glory. Satan, you have lost. You have lost. We are victorious in Jesus. We are triumphant in Jesus. We give our Father the glory for what he has done this day in Jesus' name and for our sake. Those that are standing, would you just turn, turn around. Felix is waving his hand. Just turn around. If you're standing, just turn around. Would you just follow him? He's going to show you from the Bible what you just asked for and make sure that you have the assurance. Hallelujah. Give God another hand clap. Glory.